A group of experts monitoring the COVID-19 situation in the Philippines says it's not yet time to further ease restrictions in Metro Manila and nearby areas. The Octa Research Group says while the downtrend in new COVID-19 cases is there, the number of infections remains relatively high. It adds downgrading restrictions at this time could mislead the public into thinking the situation has significantly improved. Metro Manila, Bulacan, Cavite, Laguna, and Rizal are under general community quarantine with heightened restrictions until May 31st.
While we believe that we can relax restrictions, well, we think that we should try to retain the GCQ at this time. Because the cases are still significant. So we haven't, in fact, back in February, we were at 400 cases per day, but we were still in GCQ. So it doesn't seem to be the time to relax to MGCQ at this time. It also gives us the wrong messaging to the people.
Metro Manila mayors are set to discuss the possible easing of curfew hours next month. The current curfew in the region is from 10 in the evening to 4 in the morning. But Metropolitan Manila Development Authority Chair Benhur Abalos wants this easing to help businesses such as malls and restaurants. He will meet with Metro Manila mayors tonight to discuss their recommendations for next month's quarantine classifications.
I do not want to preempt the decision of the mayors, but what I'm telling the public is this. Number one, napakaganda na, no, ng data natin. The cases are going down. Business is at least, no, it's a little more livelier than before. So for me personally, I think we could open up more businesses and we study the capacity itself, no, because we're now on GCQ with heightened restrictions. Probably, baka pwede mas luwag ang panatin.
Surigao City and six other towns in the province of Surigao del Norte placed under the second strictest quarantine level due to a spike in COVID-19 cases there. The modified enhanced community quarantine in these areas will be implemented for 1 week. A curfew will also be in place from 9 in the evening until 4 in the morning. Mass gatherings and indoor dine-in services will be banned and a liquor ban will be imposed. Surigao del Norte has recorded over 300 COVID-19 cases, 187 of which are from Surigao City. Provincial health officials sound the alarm as Cagayan de Oro City's hospital capacity reaches critical level. Cagayan de Oro currently has more than 1,300 active coronavirus infections, making up a third of the active cases in northern Mindanao. Both private hospitals and state-run medical facilities in the city have been asked to increase their COVID-19 bed capacities to accommodate the influx of cases.
We have positive cases na mild or asymptomatic, but for the abundance of caution, they would like to be confined in a hospital. No? So we're looking for a strategy. Of course, the hospitals cannot decline, no? Cannot refuse to accept them. No? But we're looking for a strategy where they would instead be housed in our TTMFs, also we need our TTMFs to be really competitive in the sense that we are able to serve those who can afford to pay hospitals in order to lighten the load.
Another area dealing with a spike in COVID-19 cases is Zamboanga City. Attorney Kenneth Beldua, the spokesman of the local coronavirus task force there, says their hospital occupancy rate is classified as high risk, even as active infections have dropped to 2,459. The city remains under modified enhanced community quarantine to prevent the situation from worsening. Officials are also taking steps to address the rise of so-called COVID deniers.
Even on a Sunday lockdown, some of our residents were apprehended having a picnic in some of our rivers. And this is amidst the situation that we are in, where our hospitals are almost on full capacity. Some of the people, even the netizens, if you will see those who make comments on the social media platforms of the city government would think that all these numbers are fabricated. I believe that with this education campaign, information campaign that we do to our residents, they will be able to understand that COVID is really real and not to wait that a member of their family gets infected.
The number of residents who tested positive for COVID-19 after attending a pool party in Quezon City rises to 55. The Quezon City Epidemiology and Surveillance Unit also says they will conduct a retest of another resident whose initial result came out as inconclusive. It adds most of those who tested positive were asymptomatic.
After the 14th day, titingnan po natin kung mayroon pang symptoms doon sa lugar. And then pag wala na po, ililip na po natin yung quarantine period, lockdown doon sa area.
Meanwhile, charges are set to be filed against the president of the Homeowners Association of the Village where the improvised pool party took place. Over a million Filipinos have been fully vaccinated against COVID-19. That's according to the chairperson of the National Vaccination Operations Center, Health Undersecretary Mirna Kabotahe. Over 3.4 million people have received their first dose of the vaccine. The Philippines aims to vaccinate at least 50 million of its population this year to achieve herd immunity. So far, the country has received more than 8 million vaccine doses.
We are still really lacking the supply. As of now, kahit mataas yung ating inventory, many of them are reserved for second doses.